All right, 720. Good morning, Jacksonville. We're hanging out here doing sports concepts and rationalizations.
Yeah.
Drew Hickens here. Sticks is here. Beef's here. It's a Super Tuesday. Don't forget the ever-popular hit program After the Drill. It's sort of like After the Final Rose on The Bachelor, starring Beef and Drew. They do it each and every day.
It's a hit.
Where do you find that?
On the 1010XL Facebook page, Facebook Live.
Facebook Live. You do it live, right?
We do it live.
Do it live.
We do it live. And here's a new cut off of the Stings album.
Okay, so that's coming up a little bit later. I understand there's going to be some car talk today on After the Drill. So
allegedly.
We'll tease ahead to that, perhaps.
Here it is. We're giving away Drew's car. The one lucky Guganella.
And by the way, you're on there whining about... whining about your clothes or something.
I wasn't whining.
And somebody sent you some Bulls apparel.
All I said was it was draft day, and all I said was, because Prosser was wearing his Hawks shirt.
Okay.
I said I probably would have had a Bulls shirt on, but I said all my Bulls gear that I love, but it's all like winter wear. It's all long sleeve, and I said I look like a clown if I showed up in a long sleeve shirt when it's 9,000 degrees outside.
I guess I can't pat myself on the back too much here through the history of our relationship. Where
I did credit you for the awesome shirt you got me.
Okay. And also, but I always think back, one of my favorite gifts that I got you. I've bought Beef some decent gifts through the years. At least, maybe not decent, but I would say thoughtful.
Got the Derrick Rose picture that I burned picture. In a fit of rage.
Yeah, but I got him a Derrick Rose picture.
RIP photo.
Back when he was MVP and hot for the Bulls. Hot. So, yeah.
About 12 meniscus go.
Yeah, 12 meniscuses. Yeah. Yes. Meniscus.
That is I just hope he could stand up for PJ's graduation. Shall we?
Let's go. Concepts and rationalization.
Let's exchange.
Is this ETN or not? Question one. I don't know.
I don't know. You know, I don't know. Round one, Dan. The the ultimately pointless NFL top 100 players list concluded last night.
Yes, it did.
As voted on by the players. The GOAT is number one. Aaron Rodgers all the way down at number 10. A lot of people on social media kind of raised eyebrows and flared up at that one, saying, "Hey, I think you flip flopped. You put one at ten, arguing that Rodgers' rightful place is at the top of the list. Is there an argument to be made that maybe Aaron Rodgers was slotted a little too low by his peers, or is that fair based on last year and the injury and everything that went along with it?"
I'm of the ilk that I think that's just fine. I'm also of the ilk of getting tired of hearing how great Aaron Rodgers is all the time when Green Bay. You know, I mean, obviously got hurt last year, 4-3 in his seven games that he started last year for the Packers. I mean, look, he had a year where he had a couple years where he was unbelievable. And I think the 2011 season is the one that stands out to everybody, where he was 45 touchdowns and six interceptions and completed 68% of his passes and threw for 4,600 yards. That's sick. Okay, but Aaron Rodgers has to win a couple Super Bowls along the way, right? Aaron Rodgers.
He's got one.
But in that year that he was so good, they lost in the first round of their playoffs.
Yeah, what's his playoff record even
9-7.
Yeah.
Which is good.
Good.
Very good.
Yeah.
It's not great, though.
Not spectacular.
He needs one more.
Does he need to win one more?
Yes.
Would going to one be
no,
enough?
No, he needs to. Not when you want to be in the discussion as
the GOAT.
Well, not even the GOAT. He's not the GOAT. The GOAT's in New England. The GOAT's done it in New England with less personnel than the little GOAT has in Green Bay.
Is he in the conversation with the other guys, the Mannings, the Breezes?
Not for me.
No, even though Breeze only has the one, too.
Yeah, I don't have Breeze is often overlooked too now.
I think people just talk about Rodgers' ability so much, but they don't look at his whole body of work really. They just see what he can do on the football field. But I think if you look at his stats and his body of work, I don't think he's as good as Drew Breeze.
Well, there you go. So he's not to me, because I know a lot of guys are like Tom Brady. Let me tell you something, Aaron Rodgers is the best quarterback in the NFL. No, he's not. Not by any stretch, not by any way, shape, or form, is Aaron Rodgers the best quarterback in the NFL. He's one of the best quarterbacks in the NFL. He's not on Mount Rushmore. He's not the GOAT.
Tom Brady would take that Green Bay team to Super Bowls, is the point.
Yes, he would.
Round two.
Round two, speaking of being disrespected by the NFL 100, okay. Our guy JR felt as though he and his brethren at the defensive back position were all disrespected by the top 100 list, as Jalen was the highest ranked defensive back at number 17. And in a passing league, is that a fair point to make that if it's such a pass heavy league, that the best pass defenders should find their place a little higher on the list?
Yes. I love Ramsey. I love what he represents. I love his cockiness. I love his swag. I love his belief. I love that he plays for the Jags. I love that he's the best corner in the NFL. I wouldn't have minded if he was in the top 10. It is a passing league. If we're going to put quarterbacks and receivers all over the place, how can you have your best defender of those two particular positions at 17? It doesn't make a lot of sense. But for Jalen Ramsey, it's still pretty doggone good because you know, he's the 17th best player, but he wasn't even on the list last year, right?
No one goes from unranked to, like, top 10, 5. I mean, it doesn't happen too often, I got
to
think.
Yeah, Clay has went 83 to 14.
Yeah, it only happens if you're injured and you've already built your name up.
Right.
And you sit out a year, and then you're out, and then the next year you're back in.
Like, J.J. Watt obviously fell way back over the past couple
correct.
Of years.
Yeah. Correct.
Shut you down!
Round three.
Round three, speaking of ranking NFL players, not as glamorous as the NFL's 100, but, you know, the Jags made a bit of a shuffle in the offseason as Chad Henne departed for Kansas City.
A shuffle.
And Cody Kessler was brought in via trade to be the backup.
Cody Kessler.
To Blake Bortles. Mm-hmm. Some feel like that was an upgrade, some less so. The gang at a Bleacher Report ranked the backup quarterback situations around the league.
We're into the old ranking of the backup quarterbacks.
It is June, Dan.
Scraping the barrel.
Well, to that end.
Did you print that up? Is that in the packet?
They did not make the packet.
Oh, no.
The Jags checked it at number 14 on the list,
14.
Middle of the pack.
Okay.
The Chiefs,
yes.
Who now are the proud owners of Chad Henne,
yes.
Checking at number 28.
Oh!
So, do you agree with Bleacher Report that the swip swap of Henne for Kessler was an upgrade? If push comes to shove?
You're not participating in
I'm
this.
I'm just telling you.
Do I agree?
Is Kessler a more capable backup at this stage?
Apples and oranges. I don't know. I'm not ready. Cody Kessler, has he won a game as a starter?
He hasn't won a game.
Is he 0-8?
But to that end,
play for Cleveland.
The numbers that, you know, it doesn't mean a whole lot.
Right.
But the numbers that he put up, this is what, in the description of the Jaguars backup situation.
Okay.
Said Kessler might have lost all 8 of his starts with the Browns in 2016.
Yeah.
But he was thrown to the Wolves on a terrible team.
Yeah.
Managed to complete 65.6% of his passes.
Yeah.
Throwing only 2 picks and posting a 92.3 passer rating during that run.
Okay. He's not the biggest dude. I don't think, well, let me put it this way. You can quibble, and he's younger, and I'm okay with getting Cody Kessler. I don't think there's that big of a disparity, 14 and 28.
If we were in this position last year,
yeah.
Would they have started Cody Kessler week 3 of the preseason?
Right. That's a good question. Also a good question. And then what would have been happened?
Great question.
Very nice.
Round 4.
Round 4, guys. Speaking of lists.
I feel like I sort of danced around that a little bit.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Speaking of lists, not so much
I didn't
list,
have an answer for you. Yes,
as it is odds.
Right.
The gang over at Odd Shark, as we head into the NFL season, has placed odds on which NFL head coach is most likely to be fired first.
Oh, no.
This season. Somebody always gets canned.
I guess.
Someone always gets canned, Dan.
Can I guess?
I think if you think about it for a minute, the odds on favorite is obvious.
Is it?
Yeah.
All right, hold on. Let me guess.
When you're 1 for 32...
Oh, you just gave it away. Dang it. Yeah, it's Hugh Jackson.
Hugh, do you agree with that? Even though people are kind of high on the Browns, at
they're
least
high. Well,
compared
listen,
to the last 2 years.
I would say this. If Hugh Jackson goes 4-12, I would fire him. They have enough talent there that they should be, unless they say, okay, we're going to play Baker Mayfield here, and they can use that as an
Your
excuse.
Your next guy after Hugh is Adam Gase. He was plus 350. Adam Gase at plus 750.
Wow. Adam Gase, he went to the playoffs his first year. He had a bad year. He lost his quarterback. He's back again this year.
Then it's Marvin Lewis, Vance Joseph. Your top 40.
Yeah, Denver won't put up with 5-11. Denver never.
No, Elway's not.
Didn't we have a stat about the Broncos having back-to-back losing seasons?
I think it's been a while.
It's like in the 60s when they're in the AFL or something. Yeah, Vance Joseph is on a hot seat. I would agree with that one. Marvin Lewis, at some point, you got to get tired of of that.
Wasn't Marvin Lewis on Stick's list a few weeks ago? Or it was either Stick's or Gibby of best coaches to never win a title. Who was it? Was either Sticks?
Was it
or Gibby.
Sticks?
One Sticks.
Probably, no. It might have been Gibby.
Gibby.
The last time the Broncos had back-to-back losing campaigns was 1971 and 72.
That's amazing. That's the expectation in Denver. So 5-11 won't cut it there. I'll give you another guy, Gruden in Washington.
Yeah, Jay was on the list.
Yeah, if he goes backwards, he'll that won't go well.
He was after Vance Joseph. Dirt Cutter Jay Gruden have the same odds at plus 1200.
Cutter's on the list.
Then
I
it's
bet.
Bowles.
Yeah.
Bill O'Brien.
Yeah.
Jason Garrett.
Yeah.
And then the last three guys on the list at plus 2,800, so still long odds. Harbaugh, Carroll, and the other Gruden.
Where's Cutter?
Cutter was same odds as Jay Gruden, plus 1,200.
Okay. Okay. So, yeah. He should be on the list.
So fourth best odds to be fired.
Well, let me
Cutter and Jay Gruden.
Let me put it in this context. You heard of Black Monday?
Yeah.
About six of them will get their slips.
And some may get it before then. I mean, what if the Browns go
0-6?
0-6.
Yeah.
Do you go, okay, enough's enough.
And you also know, by the way, the Bucs are probably going to start 0-3 now, which gives Cutter a bad hand off.
Cutter suddenly.
I might lay some money on Cutter.
Cutter jumped into the lead.
Yeah.
Round four.
That was round four.
Mm-hmm.
We're in round five.
Round
I lose
five.
Count, Dan. It's a lot going on in here.
There's a lot.
And lastly, mm-hmm. round five. Mm-hmm. While we weren't watching the NBA awards, the gang over at CBS Sports was locking down the top-tier free agents in the NBA, listing up where they would be the best fit and what's the most likely destination. And if CBS Sports is right, it's going to be a banner summer for the Lake Show as they list the most likely destination for both LeBron James and Paul George as the L.A. Lakers. If the Lakers can land both LeBron and Paul George, is that enough to at least be competitive in the West?
Competitive, yes. Certainly they'll be into the, you know what they'll be?
Who are they better than?
They'll be that's a good question. Let's take a look. They'll be a playoff team.
They'd be like the three seed.
Are they better than OKC?
Three or four seed in the West.
They're not better than Golden State.
They're better than,
than Houston.
No.
Are they better than everybody else?
I think there's always that one other team in the West, like last year was Portland.
Are they better than OKC or they're better than Portland?
Yes. Yeah, they'll be in
the, better than the Jazz?
I say 3-4-5. Okay, 3-4-5, and then maybe you win the first series, maybe you don't.
So not a championship contender, but competitive.
What do you think?
I think they need more.
Yeah.
I think if they could get those two guys and in a year add Clay?
Yeah.
And maybe Kawhi?
Oh.
Then
well, you get Clay
duck.
And Kawhi then.
Then duck.
Yeah, then they're...
Trust the process.
But understand this now. Speaking of Father Time, this is 15 and for LeBron.
That's
so
the question
now you're
mark.
Saying, okay, 16, well, they're not going to do it. And listen, LeBron may paint it like, listen, I'm going to L.A., I want to go be by my family, and I'm going to do everything I can to put this once proud franchise and get them another ring. I wonder how he feels. Kobe doesn't want him in L.A., right? Don't you get that feeling?
You get that feel.
I don't think Kobe will ever...
I don't think Kobe would
embrace LeBron.
I think Kobe would go and take the 3-4 years he's in L.A. off.
Yeah, right?
See, I'm just going to...
I wonder if that...
I'm going to Italy, maybe write a book.
Yeah, I don't know that. I don't think it factors in, but I think that's like, I'm not really wanted out here.
Could you see LeBron if he knows that if they get him and George, that they're not a championship contender? Could you see him, I'm not saying take the year off, but maybe ease off the gas a little bit?
He can't do it. Why wouldn't he
do it? I know he goes 100 miles an
hour. Why wouldn't he have done it this year? I mean, he played in 82 games. That was ridiculous.
Because then he goes to the West, and the big knock on him all these years has been, well, LeBron just runs through the East. And then he goes to the West, and what if they lose in the first or second
round? I always wanted to see LeBron with a strong ownership coach group to see how he would, because I don't think LeBron can handle that. You know what I mean? Like, if LeBron played for Pop this year, there's no way he would have played 82 games. He would have played 70 games. And so I think LeBron is so overbearing as a player, as a face of the franchise, as a teammate, as a, that he engulfs.
He wants too
the
much
coach.
Of a, he wants too much of a say is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Right. He's too involved.
He's too,
too controlling.
Because everybody goes to him and asks him, and occasionally he's going to say his opinion and, you know, this roster, we got to improve it. You know, things like that. And those things carry clout. Listen, he's never said anything wrong or bad. But again, the one thing that bothers me about LeBron James is his lack of taking, he has to take responsibility for the mess in Cleveland that is there. It's not, and it's not a mess. They went to the finals, but it's not. It's old. It's decrepit. It's not the kind of roster that's going to win a championship. But it's the one that LeBron wanted. That's all. Wow.
Another dominant performance, Dan. Impressive.
Sports Concepts and Rationalizations this week.
You blew my hair back.
I'm the best you ever had.
And I don't have very much hair.
You know what I am? I'm on fire. What are you doing? Huh?
I'm about to drink, Dan.
Are you?
This is a big watershed moment. Drew?
Drew, you're too young. You don't need that.
This is legal right, Dan.
Fire. Save that stuff for after the drill.